Hi, this is Rob with Precision Zone, and I'm going to be showing you another method of how to clear an A00 or an A81 alarm from a Yaskawa Sigma I series of drives. Now, if you have tried the first method and you're unsuccessful, this will be another option that you have to try. And this is providing that the battery is good, the encoder is good, and that the connections are good. Because if all of these haven't been checked, then this might all be for naught. You probably already know that you have a 12-bit absolute encoder if you're already this far down the road. But just to revisit it, you'll know by the nameplate. The nameplate is gonna read SGMG, there'll be a dash, the kilowatt size, another letter, and then in the fourth letter, there'll be a W. And if that's the case, then you have a 12-bit absolute encoder. And the first step in the process is to power the drive on and let it sit for 3 minutes. And hey, look at that, we got an A81. Not a super surprise. So, this second method is going to require installing a pushbutton box, as we like to call it, on your encoder cable. And unfortunately, this is something that's going to need to be soldered inside of the CN2 connections. You'll have two options on how to do this. The first one is you can remove your encoder cable from your machine, send it to us, and we'll install it. The second option is that we'll have a kit that you can buy that you can install it yourself. Whichever one, as long as you do a proper soldering job, will work just fine. So great, with the magic of video, it's magically 3 minutes later. So the next step is to press and hold that push button for at least 3 seconds, but I like to do it a little bit more than that. It seems to work better. And with the other 12-bit procedure and our other 15-bit procedure, don't be discouraged if this doesn't work on the first time. It rarely ever does. So just keep trying and trying and trying. And if you've gone at least 3 or 4 times, we'll go ahead and try something different with this procedure before we move on to saying that there might be another problem. So I think that's probably enough. Let's go ahead and cycle the drive on and off. And hey, check that out. I'm getting pretty lucky with making these videos, clearing them on the first try. So let's go ahead and jog the motor and see if it's going to operate for us. Well, hey, that's awesome. It worked out great. Now, in this reset process, you want to make sure that the battery is installed on the servo pack. And if this alarm persists after restarting the encoder 3 to 4 different times, it might be necessary to short circuit the connection terminals P and S for at least 3 to 5 minutes. And after short circuiting it, go ahead and repeat this entire process and you should be able to clear this alarm. And if you still can't clear it, please reach us at precisionzone.com and we'll figure out a way to get this alarm cleared and get your machine back up and running. Thanks for watching.